Hi friends, it's Sarah from Ruffles and Rain Boots. There is a new software version, XCS 2.6. I want to highlight a couple of features for you. The first is the Academy. So in here you have everything in case you are interested in an xTool or you have one and want to learn more. So we have a whole bunch of information on this page. It is sorted across that menu at the top. Beginners, then we have some level up stuff. This is everything from setup to leveling up. So you're gonna find a whole bunch of stuff in here and I'm not gonna go through all of it. You can see I'm just scrolling to let you see. There's some pretty intermediate level stuff as well as beginner. There are some really cool things like quick tips, and then you can even see when you hit this popular projects. Yours truly did agree to have some items inside of this academy as well, but there's a whole bunch in here, including tutorials. So this is all stuff you can access through Design Find, you can through xTool's YouTube page, but there's a whole lot of stuff in here. I just wanted to highlight xTool.com pages and then Academy. I think this is a really cool feature for the software to have right here. So I'm gonna do a project and show you some of the edits. So I'm gonna go into the AI Make inside of Design Find. Now there's a whole bunch you can do in here. If you've never been in here, I strongly urge you to check it out. But I'm gonna start with this coloring book because today is Easter. Yes, I'm making this on Easter because I thought I did this. Apparently, just in a dream. So I have to do this project really quickly and thought I'd take you along with some of the new editing features. So this is text. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. This does cost money. You can see this is gonna cost me 12 credits, I think, or something. But what I've done is just created a simple prompt in a coloring page style. This bunny is floating, there's no bottom. This one seems to be good, except for the two tails and the big little happy Easter portion. I do want to remind you, if you're using the AI Make, go ahead and remove any you don't like by hitting dislike. I always recommend downloading it because you've paid for it and then importing it into XCS at the original size. We can always come up here and adjust the size later. We don't want to lose much of our we don't want to pixelate something. So a lot of people are saying, I can't find the edit button. That is because it's in something called Cutout. We now have the option for an AI assisted editing, or you have right next to the AI, you have this manual cutout. So I just want to let you know, this is exactly what you're used to. I'm going to use the magic wand to just remove all of the background in here. I love the new hand feature, which means you can move the entire canvas to where you want. To turn that off, you just hit it again and go back to your features. So as you can see, this is engrave. This portion is the same. We can trace it. This portion is enhanced. I'm going to do a separate video on that. It does cost the credits, the same as AI Make. And we have some of the same features in case you wanted to change a photo into a coloring page. But I'm just going to go in here to trace image. It did a really good job. So I'm going to go ahead and hit save. Again, you can zoom this in and out for all the detail work you want to do. None of that is different. So now we have our options here. This means that in our layers panel, we have this new group, which is a vector set. And then below it, we have our image. Now, as you can see, two tails, we still need to edit this. So I'm going to identify the vector that I want to edit, come up to the edit menu, and this is as normal. We can come in here and remove little pieces we don't like just by highlighting the little green circles. Again, you can zoom in more if you want. Now, I still have my image layer on, so I can try and match that vector to the side of the bunny. And if you don't want that on, you just come over to the layers menu and turn off the eye for that. And you can check and edit from here. I obviously have a little bit more editing to do. Now, this is not an editing project, but I do want to say always save your files. I'm going to blow through some of this stuff because I honestly have to fix dinner for Easter and all that stuff. So I don't like this big section in the middle because I'm making a little wooden painted canvas. So I'm gonna make 4x6s for the kids. So I'm just going to unlock this and edit it. You don't have to do this, but I'm just gonna create a little guide over here. This will end up being a cut file, but I'm just gonna save and size this as I'd like. There's gonna be overlap because I get this question a lot. So I'm gonna tell you how to remove it. Okay, so once we have it kind of where we want, I'm going to go ahead and come into the basic shapes, and I'm going to add a butterfly, adding an offset, and then I'm going to cut out the offset with the original butterfly. I'm just putting it below it, highlighting both, and hitting subtract. That gives me an outline. But remember, when we're doing this kind of stuff, we want to match our outlines as much as possible, and that doesn't match. So in order to fix that, we blow it up. I know this sounds counterintuitive, but we do. Then you're going to add the same size offset here that we did, confirm, highlight all of it, and hit combine, unite. Now, when we reduce this, it's going to be the same thickness. Just a quick tip. All right, so now what about all the rest of it? I'm gonna see if I add in this little cloud over here. I don't end up keeping it, but we have some editing to do because as you can see, there's flowers on the side. I'm gonna create a rectangle and I'm just gonna make it engraved so you can see what I'm doing. I'm duplicating it to do the other side in just a second. I'm gonna highlight everything I want, lock anything I don't want, and then I'm just going to scooch in to make sure it's all aligned. Highlight both and hit subtract. Now we can remove all these little rando vectors and we can do this all again on the other side. This is just a quick and easy way to not have to do vectoring or to try and close the pass on some vector edits. So here you go, quick and easy. I'm gonna do the bottom as well and take out some of that grass at the bottom because I don't like it. I don't want it to be very muddled. For perfect angles, always use that angle tool up at the top. You can see I typed in 90 there. Then I'm gonna remove all these extras at the bottom and some grasses that I don't like just with the delete key, yay. So now we have a 4x6. I'm going to remove this Happy Easter, but in case I mess it up, I'm gonna make a copy. So I'm just gonna paste this onto a second one and we're gonna do the same exact thing. We're gonna put a shape over the top of it, highlight what we want, and then subtract out or lock everything we don't want to adjust, and then we can subtract out everything we do. And you can see it's super simple to do. Just come up to our subtract and bloop, it's all gone. I'm gonna do the rest of that little bit at the bottom after I edit out these little things like this. Quick and easy. Literally, it's taking me longer to explain it. I had to slow down some of this than it did to actually do it. So don't be scared about all this. So I am going to add in a couple of rectangles so that I can delineate this little area still in case the kids want to add flowers or whatever. I'm going to left align everything and then I'm going to duplicate it, left align everything again. And now I hate that cloud. It's going away. So I turn back on my rectangle. Now I'm going to make this all a compound path. You see, it's now one vector. So now I'm just going to align this and now we can start with some text. So I chose some pretty simple text because again, this is all going to end up a score so the kids can paint it. So I want to see how it's all going to align. I'm just going to size this down and move it into place using those smart little lock tools. You can see the little crosshairs that come up. Love that feature. Thank you so much. All right, so now we're going to convert the text to a path and set everything to score that we want. Our rectangle will be cut. Everything else is score. So now we need to do some settings. I am going to use basswood for this, but I'm going to use the quote wrong side of the basswood. I'm also going to up the default score settings to a little bit more powerful because I know my machine can do this. So instead of this 70 or whatever, you'll see me edit this up to 90 in just a bit. But for right now, we can go ahead and save this file and connect our machine. Because I already have it set up, I'm going to connect the M1 Ultra and I'm going to let you know I have a purifier on, the AP2, and an air assist. So I'm just loading a piece of basswood upside down into the honeycomb and then I'm just going to clamp it down. I'm going to place my crosshair over the material, close the lid, and hit the auto measure button. Once that's done, I can open the lid again and do my marking. So you can see, I love watching it measure. I just like that. So my marking is that next button over to the left on that toolbar. We put the crosshair in the upper leftmost and the bottom rightmost positions, hitting that white button on the front of the machine. Once we have that, the software is going to create a rectangle. We hit end marking and done, and then we just drag our item right inside that square or rectangle. So here you can see I'm going to update my settings to show 90, and then I am going to speed it up a bit as well at 65. Whatever works for your machine, whatever you've tested is great. So I am going to hit framing because I believe framing solves problems. You can see I'm barely outside of that pin, but that's what that framing does for me. It gives me a warm, fuzzy feeling that everything's gonna go okay. So when I hit framing complete, I'm gonna go all the way down to the right bottom and choose process, and then start will send the file to the machine, and then we can press start on the machine. Now you can see I am right next to the machine. I'm about to be real close. That's how loud it is. Nothing has been edited. This is real time as well. This is obviously sped up. Real time. And now this is actual cutting. And then sped up. Now I am going to let my purifier work on its own for 15 seconds. When I get the file done, you'll get this little notice. Go ahead and save your file. Once the purifier has extracted all of the smoke, I'm gonna go ahead and make sure that cut through and then remove it. Now I wanna show you right out of the machine. I don't think enough people do this. You can see there's a little bit of char from the air assist, but I always touch the edge before I do anything else because I wanna make sure it's nice and clean. So I'm just gonna wipe it off here. Now you can see the bottom and right side are clear, but we got this charring over here. So I'm gonna take it outside, hit it with 120 grit sandpaper, and then seal it for the kids to be able to paint with no bleeding. And here is the final project. I really like the new editing tools. I'm gonna go a little deeper into the AI assisted, but I did wanna answer questions that I get a lot. So editing is still there under the cutout. These are some more items that I have gone through and done in the software. Be sure to subscribe and hit the playlist for lasers to see how these are done.